Hi everyone! Welcome to Soup Dog Recipes. Today, we're making soy sauce chicken. It's a classic Cantonese dish. It's famous for its savory flavor and silky tender meat. You can definitely make this recipe in your regular pot or wok. Today, I'm going to share you some tips about how you can use a rice cooker to complete this recipe as good as the traditional way. So let's get started. First, let's talk about the chicken. You want to use younger and smaller chicken for this recipe. The older the chicken is, the stronger the meat fiber will be. If you want to achieve the tender, silky result, smaller chicken is the way to go. It is better to get one that is about 1 kilogram. If you don't want to deal with a whole chicken, you can use chicken leg or chicken wings to make this recipe. There will be a lot of fat attached. I'm just gonna trim that off. You can discard the fat if you don't like it, or you can save it to brown the chicken tomorrow. Just cut it into smaller bits and set it aside in the fridge. To the chicken, use a rope to tie the legs together. Make sure you leave a fair amount of rope at the end. It'll be helpful when you cook the chicken. Flip the chicken over, bend the wing, and tuck it behind the back. There you go. Looks beautiful, right? Set it aside. We're gonna prepare some aromatics. You will need about 1 inch of ginger, cut into smaller pieces. Smash them one by one. 8 cloves of garlic, slightly crush them as well. 1/2 of a medium-sized onion, cut into smaller pieces. Slightly smash 2 pieces of spring onion to release the flavor and stuff them into the chicken. Now, let's make the marinade. This is soy sauce chicken, so of course, you will need 1/2 cup of light soy sauce, 1 tablespoon of dark soy sauce, 1/2 cup of rice wine, 2 tablespoons of brown sugar, 1 star anise, 1 small piece of cinnamon. I like to break it apart to release the flavor. 2 pieces of bay leaves and 1 teaspoon of Sichuan peppercorn. This is optional. The original recipe doesn't have it. I just like the little numbing kick. Dump in the aromatics that we prepared before. Stir to dissolve the sugar. Put the chicken into a sealable bag. Pour in the sauce. If the sugar is not fully dissolved, use a rubber spatula to scrape it down. Push out all the air and seal the bag. We're gonna let this sit in the fridge, breast side down, overnight. This is the next day. Pour everything out of the bag. Remove the aromatics that are on the surface of the chicken. Take the chicken out and save the liquid. We'll use that later. I'm using the simplest rice cooker. It only has cook and warm 2 settings. If you got a fancy rice cooker, it will be even better. We're gonna saute the chicken fat first. Just add that to the rice cooker and spread it, cover it, and let it cook for a few minutes. For this rice cooker, if you don't cover it, there's not enough weight for you to press the button down. If you got a better one, the settings might be different. The good thing about using a rice cooker is that you don't need to worry about burning anything, because it will pop to warm setting before the ingredients get burned. Look, we got about 1.5 tablespoons of chicken fat, and the chicken bits are nice and golden. You can snack on those if you want. Take them out, and we're going to brown the chicken. If you don't have chicken fat, it is completely okay to use regular cooking oil. This is optional. I have tried skipping the browning step. It still tastes delicious. I consider myself as a perfectionist, And I do think the browning brings a little more flavor to this dish. Look at that. I'm drooling now. It will just take about 2 minutes on each side. The rope is really helpful while turning the chicken. Once you think you got enough surfaces brown, pour in the sauce along with all the spices and 1 to 2 cups of water. Different rice cooker, the power is different. You will need to adjust the water amount. If you're not sure, use small amount first and add more water if needed. Cover it, let it cook for 15 minutes to 1 hour. My chicken weighs about 1 kilogram. If your chicken is bigger, you will need to cook it longer. During this time, you want to come back every 15 minutes to give it a flip that ensures an even color on the chicken surface. Like I mentioned before, if you think the sauce is evaporating too much and it becomes too thick, you can add more water. After 1 hour of cooking, the sauce will be really thick. The chicken looks really nice. Cantonese restaurants will hang this soy sauce chicken by the window. You may have seen this if you've been to Chinatown. If it's freshly made, you can see the sauce, juice dripping down. It is so delicious looking. You can serve it whole if you prefer this way because it looks prettier. Or you can chop it up like what local people would do. I'll show you how to do that in a second, even though it is a bit annoying to eat with the bones. Use scissors to cut out the backbone. Flip the chicken. Follow the middle of the chest to cut the chicken in half. Take off the legs and the wings. Well, a traditional Cantonese chef will use a Chinese chopping knife instead of scissors, but I think scissors are good for beginners. You got the chicken breast and the chicken back. Just cut it in half. Then keep chopping each part into smaller pieces. This is a traditional and authentic way to cut up a whole chicken. In a Cantonese restaurant, the chicken will be presented in a plate like this. We usually serve this with white rice and some baby bok choy to balance the flavor. I don't have bok choy today, so I blanched some lettuce. There will be 1/3 of a cup of sauce left in the rice cooker. Drain the spices. It's very salty. I will dilute it with some water and taste it to make sure it's good. Decorate it with a piece of mint. Pour the sauce over the chicken. Doesn't that look good? Let's give it a try.
The chicken is very tender. It has a silky, smooth texture. The main flavor of the chicken is soy sauce, but you also got a mix of all that spices like onion, garlic, ginger flavors because they were cooked in the rice cooker together. You know what? I love to eat the rice with the sauce that we spooned over. It's just so savory. I hope you give this a try soon. If you did, leave me a comment, let me know how it goes. As always, you can check the description for the written down recipe and give me a thumb up, please. Don't forget to take a look off my channel and I'm sure you'll find out how to make your favorite Chinese food. New videos come out every Monday and Wednesday and I will see you next time. Bye!